Hi, welcome to Shendra's Engineering Tutorials. It's all about evaluating the expression for quality factor of an unknown impedance making use of parallel resonance. So going ahead, what is resonance? If a capacitor, if an inductor having a inductive reactance XL, and on the other hand a capacitor having the capacitive reactance XC are made a part of a circuit with a variable frequency. As we go on increase the frequency, one of the parameter increases and another parameter comes down, and at a particular frequency or a particular selected frequency, both the reactances will be equal, and that particular frequency is known as resonance frequency, and the circuit is known to be under resonance. What happens at resonance? The inductive reactance XL will be equal to the capacitive reactance XC. Sorry, it's a XC. And going ahead, so how we represent this one? It's a omega L, which is equal to 1 upon omega C. So this happens at reactance. Please remember, make a note, this equation comes into existence at resonance. Okay, so this is a backup for our derivation. It supports our derivation, right? And on the other hand, assuming a parallel RLC circuit like this one, we have a resistance R, we have a inductance L, and another loop we have a capacitor like this C, and it's in parallel, so we need to have a current source. Here it's a current source I. Now what is the total impedance of the circuit? No, rather than impedance, it would be better to evaluate the admittance. Why? Because it's a parallel circuit. So remember, evaluating the admittance would be easy rather than impedance in parallel circuit. So what would be the admittance? It's a Y equivalent. The representation for admittance, equivalent is equal to what? Equivalent is equal to 1 upon ZR plus 1 upon ZL plus 1 upon ZC is the equation, and here plugging in, it's simply resistance plus ZL, it's 1 upon J omega C plus it's a XC 1 upon J omega C, that goes up, and we'll be having J omega. Hey guys, I'm coming back, it's a for inductance, right? It'll be 1 upon J omega L. I'm taking back that statement. Now it will be omega C in this case. It's ZC, so J omega C, 1 by J omega C, that goes up, so this is the resultant, right? It's a ZL, so 1 upon J omega L, it's clear. Now a small simplification over here, 1 upon R, and this can be written as a minus J upon omega L plus J omega C, separating the imaginary term completely, what we have is 1 upon R plus, taking out J as common, what we have is omega C minus 1 upon omega L. So this is my equivalent admittance, right? So what happens to this expression at resonance? Many questions, how can you say that? How can you, in the ongoing discussion, for that to be clear, you need to focus on this one, okay? The equivalent admittance of the circuit is this. What will happen to the equation at resonance? See here, come back to this expression. So omega L upon is equal to 1 upon omega C, even this is true, and omega C is equal to 1 upon omega L cross multiplying, even this is true. This happens at resonance. So what will be the equation at resonance? This will be equal to this, in the sense we don't have this anymore. So the at resonance, I insist, this happens at resonance. Please make a note. And at resonance, these two quantities are equal, and we don't have that imaginary part, and we are left with 1 upon R. So which is the equivalent admittance. Guys, a very important statement. At resonance, the circuit would behave like it's completely resistive. We don't have any reactance, right? So on the ongoing discussion, I'll neglect the, I'll say that at resonance, I can neglect the imaginary, this is the reason. At resonance, this will be equal to this from this expression, from all this discussion, and the circuit will be completely resistive. And at resonance, we can neglect the imaginary term. This is my proof. Please make a note. On the other hand, what is the expression for the quality factor? Q is defined as Q. Previously, it was Q was for series resonance. Q will be equal to XL upon R, which is equal to XC upon R for, this is for series resonance. Now we are talking about parallel resonance. That will be parallel series resonance. This will be the expression. So for a parallel resonance, what we have is Q will be equal to the reciprocal of this one, in the sense R upon XL or equal to R upon XC. Guys, this is a very important equation. This is the expression for quality factor in a parallel circuit, parallel RLC circuit. And if this is true, even something else is also true here. For supposing, considering only this one, quality factor Q equal to R upon XL. If this is true, even this equation is true, R will be equal to what? Q into XL, or else R will be equal to Q into XC. Guys, even this is important. A very big backup will be the game changer for that expression we are in search of. We are trying to evaluate the expression for the quality factor of an unknown impedance making use of parallel resonance. We have to stick to this statement. What is this statement? At resonance, the complete RLC circuit would be completely resistive. And the second important equation is that this is the expression for this is for the series resonance, and this would be the for the parallel resonance, which is the reciprocal of this one. And from that expression itself, it's this, and R will be equal to this. If this is true, even this is true, which will be R, this one. Okay, so make a note of this one. We'll have to go ahead. Now these expressions are true. The expression for quality factor for a parallel resonance is it's R upon XL or R upon XC. And if this is true, even this is true. In the ongoing derivation, you may have a big question mark on your face. What the hell did you do? Then I'll have to look back to that one. So for that reason, I have rewritten which from there. Okay, so this is an important one. We'll have to put it aside. And what if we have a circuit like this one? A working coil inductor with L and resistance R. It's R with a wide range oscillator to vary the frequency of the circuit. Wide range oscillator from 50 kilohertz to 50 megahertz radio frequency range. And capacitor like this. For the time being, see, all are in series. Capacitor C, and voltmeter calibrated in terms of Q of the circuit. And let the capacitor value C be tuned to some C equal to C1 for resonance. And let's start the discussion from there itself. Yeah, the circuit, we have obtained the resonance, and the circuit is under resonance. So what conditions come into picture under resonance? What we have is what XL will be equal to XC, more precisely XC1. Why? Because the capacitor C is tuned to one value, C1, right? So under this one, omega L will be equal to what? 1 upon omega C1. Yeah, this is the expression, a very important expression, right? Keep that in mind. We need to plug in this one somewhere. And now this expression is very much valid for the circuit under resonance in the absence of the unknown impedance whose quality factor is to be determined. And when C subjected to C1, this is valid, okay? So we cannot neglect this one. And now introducing that impedance whose quality factor is to be determined in parallel to the capacitor over here. Like, this is how we connect that unknown impedance X. This is XP. I guess you can see this. You match your diagram with my diagram. So it will be RP over here, because we need to have the values XP and RP, and this ratio would give us the quality factor of the unknown impedance. This is of connecting, this is the circuit diagram, and changing the value C to some another level C2, obtaining the resonance condition of the circuit. Let's start the derivation. Okay, so under resonance, what happens is this impedance equal to the parallel combination of this impedance. Stay with me, that can be put in an expression like this one. What it is XP, no, XL, sorry, XL, XL will be equal to the parallel combination of the unknown impedance and the capacitance. It can be written as X, what is that? XP parallel to XC, more precisely XC2. C value of capacitor to another value. Previously it was C1 in the absence of the unknown impedance. Now it's tuned to C2 to obtain the resonance. Right? And under this case, how can this be further written as XL will be equal to XP, the parallel combination. How to write that? XP into XC2 upon XP plus XC2. So what will be the reciprocal of this one? 1 upon XL will be the reciprocal of that one, right? How to write that? XP plus XC2 upon XP plus, sorry, it's no more plus, it's into XC2. So separating for the two terms in the numerator, what we have is 1 upon XL will be equal to what? For the first term, we have XP upon XP into XC2 plus the second term plus XC2 upon XP into XC2. So something gets cancelled over here. I guess XP in this term and XC2 in this term gets cancelled, and we'll be left with here. We'll be left with 1 upon XL, 1 upon XL. L, which is equal to what? It's a 1 upon XC2 plus 1 upon XP. And yeah, guys, we are in search of this XP. So taking out, what will be this? 1 upon XP will be equal to 1 upon XL minus 1 upon XC2. Right? So more precisely, 1 upon XL. Guys, can we 1 upon XL will be 1 upon omega L 1 upon XL inductive reactance minus 1 upon XC2. 1 upon XC2 will be 1 upon omega C2, that goes up, so we'll be having omega C2. This is for 1 upon XP. And going back to that side here, one of omega L can be written as this one. So 1 upon omega L can be the reciprocal of this one. In the sense, here we can substitute 1 upon omega L with this one. It will be omega C1 minus omega C2. That's for XP. Okay. So taking out omega as common, what we have is C1 minus C2. From this expression, we can obtain 1 upon XP is equal to that. So XP will be equal to here. XP will be equal to 1 upon omega C1 minus C2, expression for XP. And the second term, we need to evaluate the value of RP, and that the ratio gives us the quality factor of unknown impedance QP. So before going that, so making use of this expression, under when introduced the unknown impedance and C subjecting to C2, what is this expression for this circuit now? So I need your attention, the more attention now. It's the heated argument now. Like for this circuit, what would be this? We need to have R even for this one, right? So R is given as, for this circuit, after introducing the unknown impedance whose Q value is to be evaluated and subjecting C equal to C2 to obtain the resonance condition of the circuit. Under that condition, R will be equal to here. R will be equal to, according to this very expression, and this is for the second time, this is for the second time, C subjecting to C2 for evaluating for the second time. So that will be that same, what Q? It will be Q2 into XL only. We don't touch this one, XL, which is equal to XC2, but I'll stick to XL only. I have a reason for this one. So XL, Q2 continues, it's Q2. And XL, if you look back over here, it's XC. In the sense, if this is XL equal to omega into omega L, if this is true, even this equation is also true. Q2 upon omega L subjecting to 1 upon omega C. In the sense, omega C1 is also true. If this is true, this is true. Even this is if this is true, this is also true. Now, this resistance is the total resistance of the circuit under resonance. Please make a note. Yeah, in red, this is the main point. This will be the game changer. We have to make use of this one, right? RT, total resistance when subjecting C2 in other level, C second tuning value C2, right? This is the expression for R total. This will be from this very expression. The total resistance of the circuit will be Q2 upon omega C1. We have to make use of this one. Okay, so we have the expression for XP and we have to evaluate the expression for RP, and the ratio RP by XP gives us QP. So before going that, evaluating the conductance of this one, GL, for conductance of inductor, how it is? It is 1 upon R plus J omega L, this one, for this one. So rationalizing the denominator, what we have is upon R rationalizing. So minus J omega L upon R minus J omega L, which gives us R minus J omega L upon R square plus into this A plus B into A minus B. Finally, we'll be reaching to omega square L square. And the whole discussion is for that under resonance, right? So under resonance, I can neglect the imaginary part. Please make a note. I can neglect the imaginary term over here under resonance. Previously, I've told you. So my final expression for GL will be equal to what? R upon R square plus omega square L square. Now this is for GL. We need to substitute in another expression. We have the expression for XP. We need to evaluate the expression for RP. And our ratio RP upon XP will give us a QP, which we are in search of, right? So in order to evaluate RP, it's better to evaluate the conductance of the total circuit. The total conductance of the circuit is given as G total will be equal to GL, conductance of the coil, working coil, plus the conductance of the impedance which is connected in parallel, GP, right? From this, which implies GP, we are in search of, which is equal to G total, total conductance, minus GL. Okay, so from this one, what will be GP? GP will be equal to G total minus GL, and G total can be written from here. GT, conductance, is the reciprocal of resistance of this one. So right, this is RT. So GT will be equal to 1 upon RT. That will be written as omega C1 upon Q2. GT is this reciprocal of this one. So inverse of that one, minus GL is this one. So writing down as it is, R upon, what do we have? R square plus omega square L square. Right, this is for GP still, which can be simplified as omega C1 upon Q2 as it is, minus, as taking out R square as common from this one and this one, what I have is R in the numerator as it is here, R square from here and R square from here. What I have is R square into 1 plus omega square L square upon R square in the denominator of the second term. And here, one of the R gets cancelled. Okay, so going ahead, what will be GP? GP will be equal to omega C1 by Q2 minus here 1 upon R as it is. Guys, can you watch carefully? This is omega L whole square upon omega L upon R whole square. That can be written as Q1 square from the previous expression. I don't have that in the board. So that can be written as 1 as it is in the numerator, 1 plus, it's a Q square, Q1 square, please go check it, Q1 square, which is approximately equal to omega C1 by Q2 as it is, minus 1 upon R as it is, 1 plus Q1 square. Q1 value will be very high, in order of 100 or 200, so 1 plus Q1 square will be approximately Q1 square. So it's written as 1 upon Q1 square. So guys, can this be written as omega C1 by Q2 minus 1 upon R into 1 by Q1 into 1 by Q1? Can this be written as Q1 square equal to Q1 into Q1? Of course, we can write that, right? So going ahead, what we have is GP still will be equal to what? Omega C1 by Q2 as it is, minus 1 upon R as it is, and into 1 by Q1 is also as it is, and a small transition in this Q1. When C is equal to C1 from the circuit, we had Q1 equal to omega L by R, which is equal to 1 upon omega R into C1. Remember this in the beginning? So now this, when C is subjected to C1, now writing this Q1 in terms of this one, it's a 1 by Q1, so omega R C1 goes up. So writing that one, this goes up, omega R into C1, when the quality factor, expression for quality factor when subjecting C is equal to C1 in the beginning. Go back to that previous expression. Now this is true, and in this case this R and this R gets cancelled. So our GP will be equal to what? It's a Q2 in the denominator. It's omega C1 minus Q1, R got cancelled. So we'll be left with omega C1. Simplifying this expression, what we have is here Q1, Q2 in the denominator, and cross multiplying, what we have is omega C1 Q1 minus omega C1 Q2. Still it's a Q1 into Q2 in the denominator. Taking out omega C1 as common, what we have is Q1 minus Q2 in the numerator. This is for the expression GP, and our RP, which we are in search of, is the reciprocal of this one. In the sense, RP will be equal to 1 by GP, which is equal to the reciprocal of that one. Reciprocal of that is Q1 into Q2 upon omega C1 into Q1 minus Q2. This is the expression for RP, and the ratio RP by XP gives our QP, the quality factor of the unknown impedance which we are in search of. So what is RP here? QP will be equal to, for the parallel here, for the parallel resonance, QP will be equal to RP by XP, which I written in the beginning, right? So QP will be equal to RP upon XP. We have RP this, we have QP this. So plugging in those values, RP is Q1 Q2 into omega C1 into Q1 minus Q2 as it is upon RP. So this gets reversed, the reciprocal of this one. It's into omega C1 minus C2. Now here, I guess omega gets cancelled in the numerator and denominator, and my final expression for QP is equal to what it is, Q1 Q2 into C1 minus C2 upon C1 into q1 minus q2, my final expression for the unknown, the quality factor of unknown impedance, making use of parallel resonance. Please make a note.